Hi everybody, this is card number 7, I believe, and it's a card and it's not a card. It is a tag in a pocket, and this is just a solid piece of 110 weight cardstock. I created a pocket to put this little tag into. We've used the tattered poinsettia, the Sizzix leaf dye that is a swirl. I've used a stamp from the Tim Holtz Stampers Anonymous stamp set, handwritten Holidays 1. The poinsettia background embossing folder, as well as the one for the tattered poinsettias. And some gold cord and some embossing powder. I used the tattered poinsettia die, brackets. Let's see, let's pull out here. You can see the on the edge brackets, and I used this one for the pocket edge. Tattered poinsettia cutting die, embossing folder, poinsettia background folder, Sizzix leaf die. I still don't know if it's from set 1 or set 2. Handwritten Holidays 1. Red tinsel glitter. A stamp from the 12 Days of Christmas stamp set, graphic 45. Some iridescent glitter. Ranger Archival Fern Green, Distress Tea Dye, Dusting Powder, and I think I already showed you the gold cord. Okay, this is a lot of fun, and it is just dead easy, but it is so pretty. How many cards have you ever seen like this? And again, I just use leftover papers. So you've got Christmas papers left in your stash somewhere. Don't know quite what to do with it. Well, you just might have enough to make this card. First thing I'm going to do is cut my papers to size. This is the 110 weight cardstock. It is really rigid. And I chose this because I have it. You don't have to use it this heavy, but it sure turned out really nice. So the first thing I need is a 5x7 base, which is this piece. Next, I need the pattern paper for the background. And this will be 4 3/4 by 6 3/4. Keeping those pieces because I'm going to use them because I have them. Okay, so 4 3/4 wide. And it doesn't matter if you're exactly the height. You could even, you know, if you didn't have a tall enough sheet of paper, you could just go just so the pocket covers it up nicely. You don't have to go all the way to the bottom like I'm doing. This one is not going to be, it's just not quite long. Well, it's exactly 6 3/4 when I cut off the top. So I'm going to take a skosh more so I have that entire border up there. So I might want to use it for something. Okay, so there's that layer. And now I need a 4x5 piece for the tag. Now, for behind the pocket, I want it to be 4 3/4 inches wide as the background paper. Let's see, not wide enough. Scrap that I cut before. So that's my pocket. There's my inside pocket. And my paper for the mat for the back of the tag. Let's see if I have any scrap of that ivory hanging around in a lighter weight. Five. cut this piece too small. It is 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. Didn't look at my directions well enough. So 5 1/2. All right, that looks much better. Okay. Now I am going to set those aside. Get these inked up and adhered together. Doing a nice distress on this. This paper actually looks wonderful with this tea dye around the edge. Nice and deep. Put it on however dark suits you, or not at all. Okay, I want to clean this off. Where is my spritz bottle? Well, I guess I won't clean it off. Just move it out of the way. I want to try to keep the back of this as clean as possible, in case I want to write on the back of it. Depending on who I give it to, it might be, you know, something silly like, you're looking in the wrong spot. I could do some decorative stamping on the back. I have the 12 Days of Christmas stamp set, so I could, you know, easily do the 12 Days of Christmas poem. Obviously miscut somewhere. Oh, I hate it when this happens. Come on, let loose. Let loose. Please let loose. Oh, I forgot that it was a little short. What a dork. Okay. That'll be fine. I'm gonna get a big shot up here. And I'm gonna cut the pieces for the pocket. These two papers. Since it's a big die, I don't need that. Here's my cutting shape, and I'm just going to center this. If you want to anchor this down, by all means, use a piece of carpenter's tape. I'm not that clever. I think I can get away with doing it like this. I really bollocks that up, so I'm going to do it again. Got it way off of center. And thank goodness. You get a couple of chances when you're doing the edge like this. I'm going to cut this at 2 inches from the point here. Line this up here and put the tip on the 2-inch line. And this I'm going to cut shorter. And it doesn't matter how much shorter you go. You need to be at least short enough that when you line this up to layer that it's not below this. So if you cut it exactly the same height, it would work perfectly. If you need economy of paper use, then just cut it smaller. I'm doing more than just inking the edge. I'm getting it onto the paper. Little bits. That's what I call, just going in a little deeper than if you're just trying to cover up the white edges of the paper. My wet glue. stamping. I could have done this before I glued it down. I don't think it matters if you do it first or second, but it's probably better to do it before you adhere it to the card. And I'm going to use Merry Christmas this time. Centered. Maybe not. Maybe I want it to the left so I can put the bow over on the right over there. On the left. Bring it to the right to put the bow on the left. I don't know how fond I am of this red from Recollections. It doesn't seem fine enough, but it is what it is, and it's what I've got. Here we go. This heat tool. Is to protect my cutting mat. The heat tool would warp it, and there's just no recovering from that. Okay. Put the cord on. Position it. Since I have a tag that's going to go slide down behind here, I am going to take my And this is just white artist tape. You can get an art supply store. It's supposed to be liftable. I find it's not so much for crafting. It really is relatively strong, and on any of the papers I've used it on, it tears the paper. So painter's tape is what I use when I want to be able to lift it off. I have this around and it makes a nice seal, so this nothing's going to get caught on here. And you could use plain tape, you could use your ATG gun and tape down a piece of paper. That's just what I happen to have on hand. Okay. Now, I really, really strongly suggest that you glue down your tag pocket. That way when your tag goes in, it won't catch on your ATG tape. I just do just a narrow bit of wet glue. And everybody knows by now how much I love Eileen's tacky glue. This is right down here. The pocket for the tag. It's gonna stay stuck. Set it off to the side. Now, let's clean this up. Because if we don't, as sure as the sun rises tomorrow, I will have this knocked over and everywhere. Anyway, okay, the next thing is to get the tag embossed. I want to do corners on it, so I'm going to use my corner chopper, and I'm going to do the half inch rounded corners, and I'm going to use the scallop. Heavy card takes the pressure embossing beautifully. poinsettia folder. Piece of paper fits in there perfectly. Whoops, can't do it that way. Embossing, cutting. Flip off those tab 1 and 2. Beautiful that is embossed. Okay. I'm going to set that aside for a minute. I have my big shot out, so let's cut poinsettia. Paper from the 12 Days of Christmas that I hadn't used for anything else. So, I need to make it a little narrower. What if I have a piece here that'll fit? No, it's not big enough. The other side's cool too, and it could certainly be used, but it's not the look I'm after. Okay, now I'm gonna cut one of the large ones. Leaves out of the screen. Cut this white strip off. Make sure I get an entire large flower. This just happens to be the paper I have. Don't go thinking you have to just, you know, you have to have this exact paper. Anything in Christmas colors would do this beautifully for a Christmas card. It'd also make a nice New Year's card or just a winter birthday using different papers. Next thing is to emboss my poinsettia leaves. There's a specific way they fit on here. And sometimes it's easier for me to find than others. Now this tattered poinsettia set, I have used a lot. I find it very, very easy to use and to come up with ideas on how to use it. This really shouldn't be so darn difficult. There we go. There are clues, for heaven's sakes. Oh, good. Now I'm going to cut the leaf swirl. Find a piece of green. Sure, we're done with this guy. Okay. piercing tool here, and what I can do about getting this guy out. It's a wonderful shape, but it is fiddly to get out of here. And all the dryer sheet rubbing in the world doesn't seem to make a difference. Glue together the poinsettia. Cut these apart because I want them to stand out from the flower and at least have a chance of looking like leaves. Use all 5 petals. Okay. Now I'm going to do some glue and glitter. Maybe a little piece of scratch paper. Here's my brush. So I'm just going to put some glue on this paper so I can brush it on. My thought is to tip the leaves and flower petals with the glitter. Okay. Not to get too heavy-handed with it. Not to get too futzy either. Sparkle to them. Okay. in it. I want to put some sparkle on this. I'm just randomly putting the glue on, except for the leaves where I'm just doing one edge. Next thing I'm going to do is take care of the mat for the back, and I'm going to round the corners, and I'm going to use the half inch corner on all four. I'm going to take my fern green and stamp my decoration on the corner. It's a bright, nice bright green without being in your face green. Very fond of it. It's a new acquisition, and I was very happy the first time I used it with the color, and I still am. Clean my stamp as best I can. This is archival ink, and if you get to it quickly, you can get most, if not all, of it off. Now you can certainly stamp a sentiment on here. Going to leave mine blank for writing on. My half inch ATG. Supplies at tapejungle.com. been buying from them for a couple of years. When I first started, the Scotch ATG was all the rage, and I bought it on a 50% Michael's coupon, because I then found Tape Jungle through another scrapper, and I don't remember who it was, and got the half inch, and I get my quarter inch tape from them too, so I use it in my other ATG gun as well, and I really, really like the quality of the tape, and it is less expensive than the name brand. Okay, a little deeper there on the tea dye. Okay, now I'm going to put a strip here and at the top. That is just to break up that field of white. I do sometimes forget, but not always too late, which is nice. So excited to show you guys things, and you know, I just go thoughtless, I guess. As in loss of thought. Tuck this in here so I don't put the poinsettia down too low. Oh, the tab. And now the tab you can make with any symmetrical shape you want. I happen to have this great Stampin' Up! Punch. I was fortunate enough to buy it before it got too stupid expensive. I really wish they hadn't discontinued it. It's very, very lovely tab punch. You could do a circle, you could do a scallop, you can do an oval, a square, or punch a hole and put a ribbon. gently working the crease because I don't want the paper to crack. And if you take your time, you can oftentimes prevent cracking. You can also moisten the area where you're going to fold. And that sometimes will help too, and sometimes there just isn't a darn thing you can do. Now, I waited to put my tab on until I had my back piece on. That way it's over both of them, and that is just really off-center. Oh boy. Can I recover from this? You know what? Whoever gets it's just going to have to understand. It was an off-center kind of day. Maybe I should have measured and marked the center. I don't usually have to do that. Okay, that's already just like totally cool, right? Okay, so here's the poinsettia. And if you want to be able to fit this inside an envelope, you're going to have to position more carefully. I figure on putting it in an oversized envelope or hand delivering. So it's going to go right there, and there's room for my swirl. Just dotting the glue on. This Eileen's, I do love it. I do. Pull that out to put the swirl down. For the center of the poinsettia, I'm going to use this little guy because I have them. I've put crystals on, a cluster of small ones, a large one. You could put a small flower in there, whatever floats your boat. So there you go. It's just not the prettiest thing. Card number 7. Hopefully there'll be more, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.